beauty is in the eye of the beholder, or so says the old cliche. Why is it then that we can be so hard on ourselves? Yasmin Kathoria has applied her brand building expertise to the subject of beauty and how a new generation of beauty treatments and products take diversity into account. Instead of trying to fit into an externally imposed model, individuals can discover their own beauty. And Carishma met Yasmin to fill in the background to this quiet revolution.
Yasmin Kathoria believes that stereotypes belong in the bin, and she's more than happy to reinvent and redefine established ideas about brands and beauty. With a bachelor's degree in psychology and the performing arts and an honors in gender equality, she's spent more than 15 years in the business of brand development. And now she's changing our perceptions of personal visual appeal. Rather than trying to imitate an impossible ideal, she is passionate about people discovering their own beauty.
Sometimes your job is something you do, and sometimes it is a true calling. The latter definitely seems to apply to Yasmin Kathoria, who uses human intuition to grow brands and businesses. Yasmin, I'm so excited to meet you today.
Amazing to meet you too.
Yasmin, tell me a bit more about what you do.
So I'm a business humanizer, working with big companies and brands to apply more human sense to business in a world that applies too much business sense to human beings.
And how did you get into the industry?
I studied psychology and gender studies, and I joined a big company, and I always felt like a bit of a misfit. I was working in business, in general management, and eventually, as my career progressed, started to work in human behavior, and that's where I found the sweet spot. It was the human behavior meeting the business, and eventually found myself where I am today.
You've had the opportunity to work with some really big brands all over the world. What made you want to come back to South Africa?
I was actually tired of working 24/7. I was based in London, working across six countries, which means working across six time zones, India, Indonesia, Brazil, often up at 3 a.m., never sleeping, and I have a 10-year-old son, so I was trying to find the balance. So I decided that I was going to join this consulting agency.
What do you think is key to building a brand?
In society today, when big companies and brands have messages which just interrupt and shout at you and say, buy me, no one really engages with that anymore. So it's really important for businesses and brands today to understand what are the issues people care about, and then you get permission as a business to start engaging with people.
How do you think social media has influenced building brands and businesses?
It has changed everything. Social media has literally changed the game for marketeers, and many big companies are hiring digital teams, social media teams. We really do need to understand that the impact that companies like Facebook and Google has had in our lives.
Tell me a bit about the beauty revolution and how the concept came about.
Beauty today is different from what it was 10 years ago. Beauty used to be about perfection, supermodels, but today it's about self-expression, it's about self-love, it's about women supporting women. So we are talking about diversity, inclusivity, all the shapes, sizes, and colors in between. It's a really important conversation for women.
Yasmin and her business partner are not only spreading their message online, they're also using events to show how an inclusive approach to beauty is the way forward. They're confident that the beauty industry is largely recession-proof, and that men and women see money spent on aesthetic treatments, makeup, and personal grooming as an investment in their personal brand. Yasmin invited Carishma to experience something of the fresh ideas and energy in the industry firsthand.
Yasmin, thank you so much for this. It's really such a treat.
You're so welcome.
What are your hopes for the beauty revolution, and how do you wish to grow it?
My dream for beauty revolution is to shift the conversation in the beauty industry, and I want more women to positively self-talk, growing each other as entrepreneurs in the beauty industry, and then secondly, using the power of words as our weapons and start to grow our own self-esteem. And that's my dream.
You're described as a brand activist. What exactly does that mean?
To be a brand activist means to create change from within big companies and showing brands and companies how to do positive social change. And that for me is a brand activist.
What do you love most about your job?
I love making an impact. For me, it's always about making sure that through my work, I have meaning and purpose. And every day I wake up and look forward to the next project, because I know that at the end of the project, we're going to have a positive impact on millions of people.
How have the roles of women changed when it comes to developing brands?
The stereotype of women in advertising is all about the mother in the kitchen, usually cooking or serving. And what we're doing is talking to brands and companies and showing them that women are multidimensional. Why are we still showing them in that one role? Often when I see advertising that has the men holding the iPad and the woman doing the washing machine, I always say, why can't we switch up roles? So we have a movement called Unstereotype, which is showing the advertising industry how to use men and women in advertising in a way that's totally breaking stereotypes.
Yasmin, you are such an inspiration and I've absolutely loved getting to know you today. And thank you for this incredible treat.
Thank you so much. It was amazing to meet you. Thanks for having me.
I love meeting inspiring women like Yasmin because everything that she speaks about is exactly all the things that I am so passionate about. I love that women are making a stand for themselves in this world and really making a change.